Good evening. My name is Brian Sewell. In the series Great Perverts of History, I'm privileged to have in the studio one of the greats, a man of whom who hath now wrote Kevin Scrotum. Welcome, Kevin.
Hello. Thank you for having me.
Alas, we have not met before. Now let me tell the viewers something about your earlier life. After showing infantile but precocious curiosity in the activities of hamsters in the rodent dungeon kept by an upper Norton Catholic primary school, Kevin pledged his life to utter depravity. In later childhood, he served as an altar boy in the Church of the Notorious, and later unfrocked Father Seamus O'Flaherty. The subject of the Southwark Cathedral Jelly Babies scandal. Kevin, how did you manage to stay being a Catholic?
No problem. That didn't stop Pope Alexander, did it?
And then on to the Desard School for Girls.
Yes, but only up to puberty. After that I was exposed and left under an overcoat. But we're poor. We could afford to send me to public school for a real education.
Ah, yes. Public school. The frissons of the rugby changing rooms and the languid swish of the cane.
Yes, you being posh, you have no idea what it's like to be poor. All we blokes have is Playboy and a group round the back of the Rackland Bag pub.
Take no notice of my accent. I only use it to infuriate the labouring classes. So, after school, what did you do?
Well, I used to be seen in gold lorry tights with a leather codpiece.
No, I meant, what did you do in adulthood?
Well, my first venture was strip bingo, but it didn't track the younger set.
Then I understand you founded the Tea Party sex cult. I believe this is modelled after St. Francis Dashwood's Hellfire Club, whose members included Benjamin Franklin.
Yes, but as early days I couldn't afford hookers dressed as nuns, so I had to get nuns to dress as hookers. But I was a great fan of Aleister Crowley, and I adopted his motto, do what thou wilt if you can get it up. And it sort of took off from there.
So what happened then?
It was investigated by Murdoch's News of the World, and membership increased overnight. Many celebrities joined, including J-Lo and Newt Gingrich.
Then I understand you opened a sex club.
Yes, I ran the Three-Toed Slofer Go-Go Club, which was alternately raided and patronised by the Metropolitan Police Chastity Squad. This is very similar to Tea Party Club, except I changed from nuns to three-toed sloths.
Sloths? Why sloths?
It's well-known scientific fact that these do not suffer from premature ejaculation. But I soon got into trouble with the authorities and had to replace the sloths with lap-dancing ferrets.
Now, Kevin, you have written many books.
Yes, my bestsellers were Cunning Lingers for Dummies and Filatio for the Dentally Challenged.
You also wrote a novel, The Story of P, but it's publicly burned by the East Cheam Ladies' Embroidery Club.
Well, it happens. Lucky I'm a bit of an artist in my spare time.
Ah, yes. Your Mother Teresa, rising in jello, received acclaim in some circles. The first time I saw it, I was wrecked with ecstasy. Now, I understand you are a member of the ancient and exalted Ordre Profession Naturelle de France.
Oh, yeah. The high point in my life.
So how did you manage to become a member of such a distinguished French body? Surely it is common knowledge in France. The Englishman cannot do it, let alone indulge in perversion.
It wasn't easy. To join one, I had to pass a stiff initiation test. I had to catch a condom with chopsticks. But I didn't last long. To advance the next plane, I had to catch a used condom with toothpicks. I failed and sustained serious injuries to my person. Oh, God, indignity.
I'm sorry.
Can you imagine it? I was dragged before the elders in their full regalia, and the Grand Master, to the sound of a drum, ceremoniously leathered my tights and... Oh, my God.
Steady, man. Go on.
And one by one, ripped pieces of God from my codpiece.
But luckily, you bounced back and went into the sex shop trade.
Yes, I developed the automatic heavy-breathing telephone machine, which was later adapted by telephone marketers for own purposes. Me Michelin girl sex blow-up doll sold pretty well. My plastic porn Teletubby garden home, not so well. And my undraped piano legs, which frankly was a disaster.
Some of your products were endorsed by celebrities.
Oh, yeah. Paris Hilton loved me nuclear-powered vibrator. She was particularly enthusiastic about this. A previous brand had blacked out half a city.
And now, in your autumn years, you have found peace.
Oh, yeah. Now I live quietly in a cave in his chain with a guinea pig called Gaylord.
But I understand even now, you have voted Dirty Old Man of the Year by Greasy Mac magazine.
Yes, you've got to keep your hand in, as they say.
But viewers, even this graceful old age, Kevin Scrotum can be seen on his Viagra-charged Harley Walker, cackling toothlessly and changing newborn naughty nurses like Benny Hill. Do you still wear the spiked codpiece?
Oh, yeah. I'll still do that for old time's sake.
Look, you have it on inside out. How does it feel?
Well, to be honest, at my age, I don't know if it gives me pleasure or not.
Well, thank you once again, Kevin Scrotum, and good night.